We created the deadly demon of pollution. We harbored it with our reckless action. It's high time to find sustainable solutions. Else, we won't be acquitted by future generations. I wish you all a glorious day. Today, we are going to discuss about National Pollution Prevention Day. Some facts, some problems, and some solutions. Students, you know, National Prevention Day is observed every year on 2nd December in remembrance of those people who lost their lives in the Bhopal gas tragedy. When the deadly gas methyl isocyanate leaked out of the Union Carbide plant on intervening night of 2nd and 3rd December in 1984. Can you believe it that the effect of that disaster are felt even now, after more than 35 years? See, thousands of people are paying the price of a little act of carelessness. So what should we do? We should take care of our surroundings. We should ponder for our every action. The objective behind this program is to educate people about importance of pollution control acts and making them aware about industrial disaster. The day aims to bring awareness among the people about prevention of air, water, noise, and soil pollution, because we have to be sensible and sensitive towards environment. Let's unfold the event one by one. Handing it over to Shivangi ma'am.
So students, let's talk about air pollution. So as you all know that what is air pollution? The degraded quality of air due to the addition of pollutants causes your air pollution. I think sabne padha hai. Hamari junior classes mein, senior classes mein, and in day-to-day life also we come across this term as air pollution. So air pollution, ki agar hum baat kare, it's really harmful because it affects your respiratory system in a very bad way. So a session was organized by Honorable Minister of Environment on sensitizing our citizens through RWAs, NGOs, and eco clubs regarding this issue, that is your air pollution. So let's talk about the components of air pollution. Basically, kya kya cheeze hamari air mein add on hokar hamari air ki quality ko degrade karti and becomes very harmful when we breathe such air. Like the very first component is your carbon monoxide, which is also poisonous. When it combines with your hemoglobin, it forms carboxyhemoglobin, and due to which the oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin decreases, and it can cause suffocation, even the death of a person. Then lead is also very poisonous. Nitrogen oxide, it leads to the formation of your acid rain, and it also causes your irritation in nostrils, eyes. Then ground level ozone, it's again really, really harmful. Then particulate pollution, or we say your particulate matter. It once added to your respiratory system, it causes lots of problems. The tiny, tiny particles, like the particles of carbon, dust particles, once they enter into your respiratory system, they cause various diseases and a lot of damage. And sulfur oxide, again, it led to the formation of your acid rain, and it causes irritation in eyes, throat, nostrils, etc. So let's talk about the very first thing, which most of the people think is not harmful. That is your particulate matter, whereas it's very, very dangerous because it leads to some of the very harmful diseases. So there are very tiny particles there in the air which cannot be seen. They are as thin as the 1/10 the diameter of your hair strand. And one, they get into your system, they causes various diseases like lungs, functioning is affected in your children and teenagers, and cardiovascular diseases are also caused by them. Then they can lead to heart attack or strokes, can cause cancer. And the thing is that they cannot be, removed by the natural defense. Like they cannot be prevented by the natural defense mechanism of human body. So it is a matter of concern for all of us. Now, when we talk about PM 10 and PM 2.5, according to the size of particulate matter, due to the implication of GAP and GRAP, that is CAP and GRAP, had led to decrease in these particulate matter from your year 2017 to 2020. And the reduction of PM 10 over 2017 is 32% and PM 2.1 is around 22%. So this is the air quality in Delhi, that is annual average of 2017 to 2020. The measures which were taken by the government had led to the reduction of these PM 10 and PM 2.5. So this is the air quality index of PM 2.5 for past 5 years. And as you can see, during winters, these amount of this PM 2, this PM 2.5 becomes really, really, really large, and it becomes it makes the quality of your air very poor and sometimes severe. So basically, during winters, these particulate matters, they settle down near the surface of your earth, and that's why they cause a lot of problem and degrades the quality of your air to the lowest. Now, when we talk about biggest contributors of pollution, for basically air pollution, are your vehicular pollution. As you all know, when we are using fossil fuels in the vehicle, and when we burn them, your poisonous gases are released. Now, dust pollution, which is all around us, then burning of substances also causes your air pollution. Now, question arises, what as a citizen we can do to prevent air pollution? So the very first thing we will be talking about is how we can reduce your vehicular pollution. As you all know, we all are very fascinated by the vehicles nowadays. But by using these vehicles, we are not only polluting the environment, we are also hampering our health. Because nowadays, most of the people prefer to use the vehicle even for the short distances. Already we have a lifestyle where we are not moving around. And where we can move, even at that time, we are using our vehicles. So we are harming our health as well as we are polluting the air. So I would suggest try to walk as much as you can. Because by doing so, you are also saving the environment and also improving your health. So try to reduce the use of personal vehicles. Try to use, if it's necessary, you want to go somewhere, use public vehicles like metro or buses. Planning trips to a minimum. If you can avoid going somewhere unnecessarily, you should avoid that trip. Then use public transport, as I have mentioned. Avoid engine idling at traffic junctions. I think you must have seen these people standing near the traffic light, and they have that banner, switch off your engine at the red light. Okay, so this campaigning was conducted last year, red light on gaddi off campaign. So when you are on red light, try to switch off your engine to reduce air pollution. Next, what we can do, as you all know, nowadays your electric scooters, electric cars are available, which are not going to cause any kind of pollution. So we should switch to such clean vehicles. Okay. So for this, the government has installed 100 charging stations, and also they are providing financial incentives to the people who are buying e-vehicles, that is electric vehicles. So we should try to switch to them. So now the next question is how we can reduce the dust pollution, which is very, very harmful because it is causing a lot of diseases in the body. So the major things which are causing your dust pollution, the construction sites, and that's why we need to monitor these construction sites in our neighborhood. So DPCC, that is your Delhi Pollution Control Committee guidelines, for construction sites are as follows. I think nowadays you must have seen that whenever there is a construction, there is a wall, a blue color wall, so that the dust particle should not come outside from that side and should can spread in the surroundings. Or you can see that a green net surrounding that building. Then one more thing is that your construction material that should be covered, that should not be open so that it cannot spread in the surrounding or neighborhood. Then vehicles which are carrying your construction material, like construction debris or any other material, they should be washed properly. Okay. Then the construction materials which can spread in the surrounding should be covered and then transported to the construction sites. So these are some of the measures which can be taken. And if there is loose soil near the construction site, that should be damped with the help of water so that loose soil should not spread in the surrounding and can cause your dust pollution. Okay. Then no grinding of your materials near the construction sites. And for the cutting and grinding purpose, they have advised to use wet jet so that when you're cutting your marble or anything, the wet jet helps not to spread the particulate matter. Then the workers who are working on the construction site should wear the mask so that that particulate matter cannot enter into their respiratory system. Then the construction sites should also recycle the things which can be recycled. Okay. And there should be proper arrangement for the medical help if needed at the construction sites. And your dust mitigation measures, that how you can prevent yourself from the dust pollution or dust pollutants, all measures should be displayed on the construction site so that if there is no awareness in some of the people, they can just read those guidelines and they can make themselves safe from that dust pollution. So some other measures to reduce dust pollution: potholes on roads, accumulation of dust on roads must be avoided, and unpaved roads. So lastly, I would like to share a very good initiative taken by the Delhi government, that is Green Delhi app, which was launched in October 2020 to report about the pollution. So basically, if there is a construction site and they're not following the guidelines, you can complain about them on this app, because those construction sites are harming a lot of people in the neighborhood. So you should kind of take an initiative and report such sites. So around 27,000 plus complaints were received till date through this app. And 93% of those complaints are already resolved. So I think, so these were all the different kinds of complaints that you can make through this app, that if potholes are not covered on the road, illegal dumping of garbage on roadside and vacant land, illegal dumping of C&D waste on roadside, public land, flood plain of Yamuna, then air pollution due to industries, if there is some illegal industry in the neighborhood, as you all know that industries are not allowed in the residential areas, then air pollution from the sources other than industry, if there is some vehicle which is causing pollution, which is very old and that need to be replaced, burning of biomass, garden waste, burning of garbage, plastic waste, dust pollution due to construction, demolition activities, road dust, noise pollution from the sources other than industry, visible smoke from vehicle exhaust, etc. Now, prevention of open burning. Like we all see that some people used to get rid of the waste by burning them, like solid waste, burn it, garden waste, Now during winters nowadays, people used to burn like wood or other things to get some warm. Now how this can be prevented? So vigilant and report open burning in dumps and gardens. If you see something like that, you can report it on the green app. Then sensitize malls and MCD workers. We should sensitize the people in the surroundings regarding this. RWA is encouraged to distribute electric heaters to security guards and laborers. So as these people are working in very cold atmosphere, so they should be provided with electric heaters so that they will not burn the things to get that warm. A fine of rupees 5,000 upon open fires will be charged. Winter action plan from government department. So there is a special winter action plan, as we have seen that the air pollution is at its peak during winters. So action plan prepared by all department, road sweeping, sprinkling, pothole repair, paving and greening. These all measures will be taken so that there will be less pollution during the winters, and regular monitoring will be done. Other crucial precautions that should be taken, that is sale and bursting of crackers should be banned for any purpose. We should increase greenery as much as possible, as you all know that your plants, they provide oxygen and they also consume carbon dioxide gas, and they kind of settle down the dust particles on the leaves. So they help in decreasing the air pollution. Now, the very important thing, creation of awareness by RoHS, NGOs and eco clubs. So we need to sensitize the people regarding this issue, that if we are not improving ourselves to improve the environment, in the long run, we are going to be affected by the outcomes of our activities. So we really need to sensitize all the people in the surrounding and our family members as well. So that's all for today. I hope that everyone will take all the safety measures that need to be taken as a citizen of India, and will sensitize more citizens like your friends and family to reduce air pollution. Have a nice day, everyone.
It was quite insightful, ma'am. Now, the students of 7th and 8th class are going to present a pollution song for you all.
Breathing.
what a wonderful song with a really strong message. Now, Tejasvi of 9th class is going to present a speech for you all.
Wish you a gracious day. This is Tejaswini Sharma from Little Flower Public Senior Secondary School. I am just 14 years old, but I have undergone more than enough transitions. But I would like to share about air pollution, which has become a major challenge in recent times. Had anyone heard of air purifiers earlier? No, but we are bound to think about it. First of all, we create problems and then condemn others. Friends, now is the right time to take action. We know that people experience a wide range of health effects from being exposed to air pollution. This severe pollution level in Delhi is an alarming situation for all of us. But I believe that sooner or later, we will combat the air pollution by being sensible and sensitive. The government is taking many steps to control air pollution, like phasing out old vehicles, use of unleaded petrol in vehicles, use of low sulfur petrol and diesel in vehicles. Delhi government has also installed anti-smoke guns at large construction sites in the national capital to control air pollution. We must support and contribute to the solution. I have planted many air purifier plants and we also gift the same to our near and dear ones. So, I would like to urge all the viewers to ensure our right to breathe in fresh air. Each one has the power to be the change maker. Thank you.
I believe now all of you are very well aware of the current present pollution situation and are ready to be the real game changer by taking necessary steps to protect and restore the beauty of the environment. Let's unite for this mission and make it successful, because this is what we are going to give to our future generation. Thank you all.